Today we're going to take a page out of NASCAR's book and just keep turning left.
3, 2, 1,
Lego! We want our robot to follow this black line and loop around the test track. To do this, we're going to have to use the color sensor. The color sensor can detect the amount of ambient light in the room, reflected light back, and loosely what color something is. Using this calibration strip down the side, we can see that the robot lumps colors into different categories. These shades of yellow are seen as a 4 or a 7, and red is seen as a 5. White is a 6, and black is a 1. We want the robot to follow this black line around the track, so we're going to place the color sensor on the line. And it's going to drive forward, and eventually it's going to go off the black line. So we're going to need it to turn left until it finds the line again, and then continue to move forward. We can use a loop, and we can tell the robot to continue to move forward until it sees white. And then it will exit the first loop and enter a second loop. And in the second loop, we're going to tell the robot to continue to turn left until it sees the black line again. We nest these two loops inside of an infinite loop, so the robot will get back to the first loop again. This program works pretty well for this simple track, but what if we have a more complicated one? We want the robot to find the red line and follow it forward until it hits the yellow line. Then you want it to turn to the left so it can easily drive straight along the yellow line until it hits the second red line, and then it's going to come to a stop. Using the port view, we see that the robot sees yellow as 4 or 7, and it sees red as 5. To make all these choices, we would need a lot of loops. So we are going to ask the robot to make choices with switches instead. In programming, it's also sometimes called an if-else statement. We can find the switch in the orange flow tab. The first thing we need to do is ask the robot a question. If the color sensor sees red, which is a number 5, then you need to do what's in the top half. And if not, you need to do what's in the bottom half. So if it sees red, we want it to move forward just a little. If it doesn't, we want it to nudge it to the right just a little. Unlike the last track, the robot sometimes needs to go to the right and sometimes needs to go to the left in order to find the line again. This is why we're going to duplicate the first switch we created and make the robot wiggle back and forth. You want this value to be different than it is in the first switch, because if you make them the same, it will wiggle back and forth right in the same spot. All of these are smaller values because you wouldn't pull your steering wheel hard to the left and then hard to the right. You would make small corrections as you drive. We are putting these two switches inside of a loop. We want the robot to exit this loop when the color sensor sees yellow. Then we want to change the robot's orientation, but just do it once. So we're going to put this move block outside of the loop. Now it should be facing the yellow line a little bit better. To follow the yellow line, we're going to use two switches again. So we can just duplicate what we had in our first loop and change some of the numbers. This time we want the robot to look for yellow. If it finds yellow, we want it to move forward. And it's more likely that we're going to need it to turn to the left. So we're going to increase the number of degrees that this wheel rotates. And finally, we're going to need it to exit the loop when we find that last red line. If you have any questions or comments, you can leave them down below, and you can also talk to us on Twitter, Tumblr, Reddit, Facebook, or Instagram. And remember, keep exploring.